Hi there. In this video, we're going to have a look at some key research that's compared laptop versus longhand-based note-taking of lecture material and consider its implications for the way you go about taking notes generally. Laptops are becoming an increasingly common sight in lecture theatres. And assuming for a moment they're being used to take notes as opposed to check social media, this does rather beg the question of whether there is any demonstrable advantage to using a laptop to take notes over writing notes out by hand. In an often cited study, Mueller and Oppenheimer 2014 compared longhand handwritten notes with laptop-based note-taking in terms of the quality of the notes produced and also on the students' subsequent performance when tested on the material they were taking notes about. They suspected that because most students can type faster than they can write, well, legibly anyway, that the use of a laptop might promote more verbatim transcription of the material, and that this inferior form of note-taking would manifest itself in poorer recall of the material being studied. In their study, students were randomly assigned to either a longhand note-taking condition or a laptop-based note-taking condition. They were then asked to watch one of five 15-minute TED Talks. Students in both conditions were instructed to take notes as they would in the course of a normal lecture. After watching the video, students were taken to a different room and given a series of distractor tasks for a period of 30 minutes. Following this, students were tested upon their recall of the material contained within the TED Talk and also on their ability to apply concepts that the TED Talk had covered. As predicted, the researchers found that students in the laptop-based note-taking condition produced more extensive notes, but that these notes contained more verbatim copied content than students in the longhand note-taking condition. Students in the laptop-based note-taking condition also performed worse on the conceptual questions relating to the TED Talk they just viewed than students in the longhand note-taking condition. Mueller and Oppenheimer wondered whether the tendency towards verbatim note-taking in the laptop-based note-taking condition could be negated by a timely warning about verbatim note-taking and some advice on better note-taking practices. So they replicated their experiment with one important amendment. This time, the laptop-based note-taking condition was split into two further groups. One of these groups was forewarned about the risks of verbatim note-taking and advised to write notes in their own words and not simply copy down what the speaker was saying. The other group was just told to take notes as they normally would in a lecture. However, it turned out that this intervention made no difference. Verbatim copying and assessment performance did not differ significantly between the group that were forewarned about verbatim copying and those that were just advised to take notes as they normally would in a lecture. Having noted that the students in the laptop-based note-taking condition were producing more extensive notes than those in the longhand note-taking condition, Mueller and Oppenheimer wondered whether the students in the laptop note-taking condition simply needed an additional opportunity to review their notes so they could benefit from the additional information they'd captured. So they replicated their experiment once again. But this time they introduced a 7-day delay between viewing the TED Talk and being tested on its contents. They also divided the laptop-based note-taking condition and the longhand-based note-taking condition into two further subgroups. In one group, the participants were given the opportunity to review their notes 10 minutes before taking the test, and in the other group, the participants were given no such opportunity. The trend for students in the laptop-based note-taking condition to write more, but also produce more verbatim content, persisted. For students in the laptop-based note-taking condition that were given the opportunity to review their notes 10 minutes before taking the test, the amount of verbatim content in their notes correlated negatively with their test performance. In other words, the more verbatim content they had in their notes, the poorer they performed on the test. Students in the longhand note-taking condition that had the opportunity to review their notes 10 minutes before taking the test outperformed the other groups in terms of their test performance and also demonstrated less verbatim content in their notes. The Mueller and Oppenheimer study has received much attention since its publication, and it's no doubt influenced much of the advice given to students about effective note-taking practices within the mass media. But in 2019, Morehead and Rawson argued that to definitively conclude that it's better to take notes using longhand than via a laptop PC, based on the results of one study that had yet to be replicated, was premature. Accordingly, Morehead and Rawson replicated the Mueller and Oppenheimer study. And in keeping with the results of the Mueller and Oppenheimer study, they found an advantage for students taking notes via longhand over those using a laptop PC. However, they found that the differences between the two forms of note-taking were small and statistically insignificant. Thus, these differences were not a suitable basis for firm recommendations about whether students should use longhand or a laptop PC in producing their notes. So what's causing the inconsistency in the results of studies that have compared laptop-based note-taking to longhand-based note-taking? Well, I think this is at least in part due to the fact that these studies haven't properly controlled for the approach that students use in taking their notes beyond simply monitoring how much verbatim content from the original source is present in their notes. Yet we've known for some time that the specific approach a student uses in taking their notes can have a significant impact on their memory performance. We also know that variations in the degree to which someone executes a particular note-taking strategy, such as summarisation, effectively, also has a significant impact on memory performance. In other words, it's how a person takes notes and whether they execute that note-taking practice effectively or not, that is likely to be much more important in determining their memory performance than just whether they used a laptop or longhand in producing the notes. It's also worth noting that the conditions under which participants viewed content in experiments comparing laptop-based note-taking with longhand-based note-taking are somewhat divorced from the conditions under which students now view lecture content. For example, the increasing availability of lecture recordings that you can play, pause, rewind, and fast forward at your leisure has made the act of frantically scribbling down notes about that lecture as the lecture unfolds increasingly redundant. So there is a need for research into note-taking to more accurately capture the conditions under which students view lectures in a contemporary university setting. So where does this leave you? Well, my advice would be not to fixate on whether you're using a pen or a keyboard to produce your notes. If there is a difference between laptop-based note-taking and longhand-based note-taking in terms of memory performance, then that's much more likely to reflect the particular note-taking strategy being used and the extent to which the notes capture the assessed content, rather than whether those notes were produced with a laptop or via longhand per se. It's certainly good advice to avoid verbatim note-taking, as we know that this isn't effective in helping you remember what you're studying. In contrast, basing your note-taking around a process such as elaborative interrogation, where the onus is upon you to produce how and why questions concerning the key content of the material you're studying, and then answer these questions in your own words, is much more effective. I'll put a link to a video that I've produced on the process of elaborative interrogation in the top right-hand corner of the screen. Finally, if you're attending or remotely viewing a live lecture that's being recorded, I would suggest that you focus your attention on the lecturer rather than frantically trying to scribble down notes. You can view the lecture recording afterwards and make notes at your own pace. This will give you the time and capacity to identify key content, think about and question the material, and compose notes in your own words. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please do hit the like button. If you haven't already, why not subscribe to my channel for more information on how psychology can help you study more effectively. If you want to know when I post new content, then just turn on the bell notification. Thanks very much.